Hey everyone, welcome. My name is Dmytro Mshensky and from scratch. Hey, what's up guys? My name is Dmytro Mshensky and from this video you will learn what is going on under the hood when you try to execute some Angular CLI commands like ng build and when you hit enter. What is going on after that? And this is just a first video in the very, very tiny video series. There will be two videos where we will eventually build a custom builder for Angular CLI. This is something I promised you to do in this video. We had agreement if that video will reach 1000 likes, I will make this one. And yeah, I hope you will learn a lot from this video series. So yeah, stay here and then let's just get started. All right, as I said, today we'll just have a look at how Angular CLI resolves and executes builders. For that, we will be using a simple Angular application I prepared for this exact lesson, and it does very simple stuff. It just renders the app version right here and the date of build right below. This data comes from the JSON file that is located under the assets folder in my application right here. And if we open it, you can see some information about the application build that I will be eventually using. And this information I'm actually fetching inside my app component. And I'm doing that just by, you know, firing the HTTP call to that build JSON file. And then the information that I receive from that, I just render those data inside the component view right here, as you can see it right now on the screen. And it is a small teaser, but in the end of this short video series, we'll make a custom builder that will be patching this build information whenever I run my custom builder. But as I mentioned in the very beginning, in this exact video, we'll learn more about builder anatomy and how the builders are being executed by Angular CLI. And the custom builder itself we will build in the next video. All right, but let's move forward, and I would suggest you start checking the Angular JSON file and check out the already existing builders and their structures. So each project in Angular Workspace has a set of so-called architect targets like build, serve, etc., etc. Those are targets that you call when you run a command ng build, for example, and once you run it, once you press enter, the build architect target will be executed. So I hope it's quite obvious and simple. But the architect targets isn't the builder itself. Yeah, it is more, let's say, high-level construction that contains already a builder itself, which is basically some JS scripts that export some specific function that contains the builder logic. And the builder has also options that can be provided for the builder function as a builder function argument. And also it can have configuration, which is basically a set of options for some concrete configuration like production, development, or whatever else configuration you might have. We'll talk a little bit more about it later in this video. And optionally, the fourth parameter is that you can define some default configuration as well in order to not provide it explicitly. But for now, let's get back to the builder property and let's have a closer look at it. And yeah, let's maybe zoom it a little bit so it will be comfortable for those who watch the video from their mobile devices. You're welcome. And as I said, essentially the builder is just a simple Node.js script that exports almost a simple function. But from this notation, it is not really clear which exact script will be executed and how all those stuff will be resolved. So I would suggest you to demystify this part. And believe me, guys, once you get it, it will be way easier to understand things we will be building later in the next video when we start to implement our custom builder. And as you can see, the builder string is split by a column into two parts. The first part is actually a path to the builder package. It can be a relative path in case if your builder located on your computer, but in under some another folder, you can provide a relative path to it. But in the case of this exact builder, it comes from the installed npm package, and it is called this package called angular dev kit/builder angular. This package you can easily find under the node module folder actually, and it is obviously in our project root folder, and there just find the angular dev kit, and there you can see the build angular package installed that was actually defined in the angular json file, right? Okay, I hope it is clear so far. And then the second part of the builder string, it is already the name of the builder that has to be eventually executed, right? And in this case, it is called browser, but it is still not the direct pointer, so to say, to the script that has to be executed. So that's why let's figure out how it is actually resolved. So you run, for instance, ng build command for some certain project, right? What happens then? Angular CLI finds the corresponding target build, and then it will try to execute a corresponding script for that builder. So Angular CLI sees that, all right, the path to it is the following package. So it goes right to that package, right? And then it tries to figure out if its package.json file, which must exist for every npm package, if this package.json file contains a property called builders. You can see that it has such a property, and it points to the builder.json file that is located on the same level as this package.json. So ng-cli goes there, and inside the builders property, it tries to find a builder where its key matches the build name that was provided after the column right here in the angular.json file. So it means that for the build architect target, there will be resolved this exact builder. And the builder itself also has three properties. Two of them are required: implementation and schema. Let's get started with implementation. This is a required property, and it contains the path to the Node.js script that has to be executed. And you can even follow that path and find this JavaScript file right here, as you can see. Yeah, you can see that a lot of scary code here, but regarding the code of the builder, what you can do there, This everything we will cover in the next video. So if you are not subscribed to my channel yet, then you can subscribe to it to not miss that second video. But yeah, let's get back to the topic. And yeah, we can close this source code of the files and we can get back to the second required property called schema. And schema, it contains the path to another JSON file that describes properties that are available for this exact builder. So if you follow this path and find the corresponding schema JSON file, you will see the list of already familiar properties and also their types. So for instance, here you can see the property assets that have a type array, and it is nothing else as a description of the same property we provide for this builder inside the AngularJSON file, which is actually an array as it was described in the schema.json file. And by the way, talking about the builder options, things you define here in the AngularJSON file can be provided also in the console, yeah, when you run your builder. For instance, if I want to run this builder with a different tsconfig option, I can run the ngbuild command and provide the tsconfig option just like that. And there I could provide some alternative value. And by the way, keep in mind that properties that are provided in the console, they will override ones in the AngularJSON file. So they have kind of priority over what you defined in the AngularJSON file. All right, I hope it is clear. And now a few words about configurations. They are actually the way of grouping some builder options we covered before into some set of options that are relevant for some certain configurations like production, development, staging, etc. So we can basically say that options right here, they are kind of shared options, right? They shared for each configuration, doesn't matter if it's production or development. And there inside the certain configuration, we can provide or override some specific options for some specific configuration. I hope it makes sense for you. And the last option that is available for the builder is default configuration, which is actually self-explanatory. It's just a default configuration that will be picked if you don't provide the configuration explicitly, right? And yeah, this is pretty much everything I wanted to show you regarding the builder. So it consists of four options: the builder itself, the builder is just a Node.js script that contains some function that contains the logic which has to be executed by this builder. Every builder has options. Options, they're described by a dedicated schema.json file where you can where there will be listed available options, their types, default values, etc., etc. And you can group those options by some certain configurations in order to execute builder in some certain mode, right? All right, guys, that was it. I hope you enjoyed this video and it was useful for you. While you're waiting for the next video, you can subscribe to my channel to not miss it. And you can check out my video courses, especially the last one dedicated to advanced Angular forms, where I also do a deep dive into Angular forms. We'll investigate source code and eventually build a super cool select drop-down component that supports multi-selection and a lot of cool stuff. So check it out. There could be some discounts because currently I'm running Cyber Week promotions. Anyway, all the necessary links will be in the video description, so you can go and check it right now. And I wish you a productive week ahead, stay safe, and see you in the next video.